Good morning, everybody. Welcome to Coffee and Conversations with the one and only J-Man. Your morning will never be the same. Here we go.
Good morning. You're listening to Coffee and Conversation with your boy J-Man on Spreaker.com, iHeartRadio, Spotify, and all the other platforms that we're on, even Alexa. That's right, Alexa can make it do what it do. I hope you all are having a great week, that your week has started off good so far, that you had a wonderful weekend. Let me give a shout out to those that's in the chat room. Dr. Tony, good morning to you. Thank you so much for being on this morning. I really do appreciate it. Thank you so much. To Emory Winship Cancer Center. Emory Winship Cancer Center, good morning to you all. I'm not sure if you all are on yet or not, but good morning to you all. To all the nurses, doctors, the receptionists, everybody that works up there taking care of my warriors up there. Thank you so much. Thank you so much. For being there for them. I really do appreciate it. I do solicit your prayers. I lost a family member yesterday. Thank you all so much for those that have already contacted me via social media or personally. Thank you all so much for your love shown to me. I appreciate it. And my family, I thank you so much. I want to ask a question concerning, and it was kind of dealing with what we dealt with last week, at the end of last week, Thursday, about baggage. My question now is, what's in your hand? What's in your hand? What's in your hand? Biblically speaking, God asked Moses, what was that in his hand? In other areas, you can read about people using things in their hand. They were able to fight with something in their hand. They was able to build because they had something in their hand. So my question to you all this morning is, what's in your hand? In other words, what is being, is what in your hand being useful to you? In other words, the knowledge that you have, the ideas, the witty ideas that you have, or is the word procrastination a part of your, for the lack of a better word, baggage? Is procrastination something that you would put, that you have in your baggage, or do you have all the necessary tools in order to change your life for the better? Change your life for the better. Are you actively seeking to do something to be better by using the gifts that God allowed you to have? I know sometimes we don't consider those things. One of the things that I don't know if this is a good way to say it, but I'll say it this way anyway. I praise about the pandemic. It showed people how smart they was. It showed people how creative they can be. It showed people the gifts and the talents that was lying dormant within them. These gifts and these talents has caused a shortage in a lot of different areas, a lot of different industries, because people aren't returning back to work in some of those industries, the hospitality industry, the food industry. A lot of people aren't returning because when they were out, when they were forced not to go to work, they had to still make money. And what they did was use their gifts and their talents. There is a way, ladies and gentlemen, there is a way that your life becomes, it may be good now. It may be good now, but it can be better. There are avenues that you can take to make it even more better. Better. We can't. I was talking to someone a while ago, a couple of months ago now, about how we pray and we pray, God, I want this, God, I want this to happen for me. I want this to happen for me. I want this to happen for me. And they pray all the time and nothing happens. The reason why nothing happens is because you do nothing. You could pray all day, but without movement behind your prayer, without actions behind your prayer. Faith is an action word. Faith is an action word. You have to do something in order to have faith. Otherwise it would be called a wish. There's a difference between having faith and making a wish. A lot of times we pray to God in a manner of making a wish rather than having faith, asking God in faith, and then going out and doing something. And if you just simply, I'm using the metaphor hand. If you just pay attention to what's in your hand, if you pay attention to what's in your hand and use the gifts and the talents that God has given you to make a better journey for yourself. Many times, many people may feel frustrated. They're on their jobs frustrated. They wake up in the morning frustrated. They go from this thing to this thing because they're frustrated. And the reason they are frustrated is because they're not using the gifts that's on the inside of them. Because your gifts are the things that make you uniquely you. It makes those that's around you to witness someone unique. And your applause from the crowd comes from using your gifts. If you're frustrated in whatever industry you're in, whatever moment you're in, no matter what it is, and you just feel as if I'm not getting the credit I need. I'm not getting the right this and the right that. Begin to use your gifts. The world is waiting on you to show up. Matter of fact, you as a gift, the gift that you are is for the world. The problem is a lot of times we have not presented ourselves to the world so the world can unwrap us and see what a benefit it is of us being in their lives. Begin to use everything that God has. In some cases, it may seem strange to you. That gift, that talent may seem strange to you, but you may say, no, they're not going to dig this. They're not going to like this. They're not going to want this. I guarantee you, if it's something that's burning on the inside of you, it's for you. In Sister Act 2, in the movie Sister Act 2, Whoopi Goldberg's character is talking to Lauren Hill's character on the side of the corner. And Whoopi Goldberg's character basically tells her, baby, if you wake up in the morning, every morning and all you do is think about is singing, then baby, you're supposed to be a singer. I would venture to tell you all this. If you wake up in the morning and it's something always at the bottom of your heart, I want to do this. I want to do this. Oh, I would love to do this. And you play around with it and you tinker around with it. But you find so much joy and so much peace in doing that thing. Maybe that's what you're supposed to be doing. It's never too late to go after something. It's never too late to go after something. I don't care how old you are. Go after it. Go after it. Look, I appreciate you all hanging out with me this morning. I'm going to cut this one short today. You all have a great day. Be good. And may God keep you. I'll see you all Thursday. You all have a great day. Bye-bye.
You're broken down and tired of living life on the merry-go-round. And you can't find a fighter, but I see it in you, so we gon' walk it out. Move mountains. We gon' walk it out and move mountains. And I'll rise like the day. I'll rise unafraid. I'll rise up, and I'll do it 1,008 times again. And I'll rise up, I like the waves. I'll rise up, in spite of the ache. I'll rise up, and I'll do it 1,008. silence is a quiet, and it feels like it's getting hard to breathe. And I know you feel like dying, but I promise we'll take the world to its feet. Move, I won't dance. Bring it to its feet. For that we have each other. I will rise a thousand times again, and we'll rise.